Does it help to have a lot of patent claims? No. In this video, I look into whether a lot of patent claims help a patent. I give you my personal opinion in advance. Generally, a lot of patent claims do not help except with prosecution. In this video, I look into the three different stages in the life cycle of a patent. First, the prosecution, then nullity actions, and then enforcement. I looked at over 13,000 opposition cases at the European Patent Office, and in this video I give you a first analysis of my findings. In my opinion, the only stage in the life cycle of a patent application is the prosecution. The European Patent Office sometimes objects to a lack of disclosure for a combination of features. So a lot of claims can help that because you can have multiple dependencies and have all the features in the different claims. And then of course you have multiple dependencies, so you can combine any combination of features that you want that are disclosed in the claims, and you will not have a problem with lack of disclosure for that particular combination of features, and you will not get an objection with regard to Article 123, unallowed amendments, and you will not have a problem later on in opposition with Article 123. But mostly, a lot of claims only help in prosecution, in my opinion. Let's look at the opposition phase or the challenge phase, for example, also nullity actions. I have looked into more than 13,000 opposition cases at the European Patent Office, of course in an automated manner, and have analyzed these decisions with regard to different features or different properties. For example, the number of claims, the length of the claims, the language of the proceedings, the language of the country of the representative, the country of the priority document, and about 100 different parameters. And as for the number of claims, I found the following. Oppositions are rejected in about 17% of all cases where we have 21 claims or more, whereas the opposition is rejected in 25% of all cases where the number of claims is between 2 and 10. On the other hand, the patent is maintained in amended form in 38% of all cases where the number of claims is higher than 20, that means 21 and more, and the patent is maintained in amended form in 29% of all cases where the patent has between 2 and 10 claims. As you may know from your own experience, opponents typically allow maintenance in amended form if the potentially infringing product is not falling under this new amended form. So it is likely that opponents no longer attack a patent if they fulfilled their goal in not infringing the patent anymore. While many claims offer more choice to amend the claims in opposition proceedings, the numbers show that many claims typically do not help in maintaining the patent in a useful form. And in the litigation stage, well, the most important claim is the independent claim or the independent claims. So the dependent claims are sometimes even a hindrance in litigation because they are sometimes used to interpret the independent claims. So if you don't have a lot of dependent claims, there is not much room for additional interpretation of the independent claims. In my personal view, during litigation, a patent with only very little dependent claims is most useful. I hope I was able to explain why many claims may not be helpful in a patent application. If you are new to my channel and want to keep updated about patents, trademarks, and designs, please subscribe to my channel. If you liked the video, hit like. I am answering questions in the comments, and most importantly, protect your intellectual property and go make it count.